Meditation irons out all kinds of creases. It's not just for attaining spiritual growth. It is not just for peace of mind. It is not just for health reasons. It encompasses everything. In our days, there was not much of choosing involved. Father would say, Padho Emperliasi. Life takes you somewhere. More you plan, I think, more we will falter. Best is either you decide it for yourself, or ask your parents, or ask your colleagues. Or nowadays there are professionals, you know, who will guide you which field to select. And based on your talent, they will guide you. I think that would be ideal for you. Often, you know, there are fancies, you know, especially in the West, where if they love music, they'll say, oh, I'm going to become a musician. In India, music is something that it's a side thing, you know, you learn on the side. So we have to choose, oh, I like music, should that become my profession? Should I study, go to college for 4 years and waste 4 years learning music? No, I wouldn't advise that. You can learn music, but don't waste 4 years in getting degree in music. Once one sister came all the way from Europe to study music, and then after she finished music, she came and said, I want to do master's in music. I said, proceed. And then there was a PhD thing. Each time I told her, why are you wasting your life? This was in the 80s. I said, look, even if you become a good musician, you'll still have to stand with your cap on a railway station and play your music so people will throw coins. If you are the best, then you did not study. Best musicians, they don't study. It comes from the heart. Whenever I meet her in Denmark during the seminars, she tells me, I should have listened to you. Now she has two daughters, a divorced life, always depending on state to help her life, you know, pass through easily, struggling. But if you had studied something worthwhile, you could have worked. So always, it's not necessary that you pursue your fancy dreams and say, oh, I'm going to become a musician or a painter and things like that. It should be adopted as a side hobby. But study something worthwhile that can support your life. And if it happens to be a field which you like as well, then it's worth it. It's even... It's like Sonam as you can say. Make money as much as you can. Integrate spiritual life with your material life and remain on a cutting edge technology. Integrate your family with spirituality so that new future can be created. See, you could be materially successful, but if you don't give this spiritual heritage to the next generation, I think they will remain rudderless. I'm often bombarded by such questions like, what is the reason behind success, academic success or financial success or health-wise or family-wise or spiritual success? The simple answer to me is always a meditative mind, mind that is full of awareness, conscience, will guide such an individual. Out of 10 choices that we may confront, how would you filter and with confidence, with courage, you can say that under these circumstances, if I do this, it's the most appropriate. That means I have to highlight all those which will not be as effective. Meditative mind can easily filter out what is not essential and will simply focus on the most essential. While you are studying in your academic world, running a family life, even to begin a family, for example, whom to marry. Such simple questions, which business to start, which college to go to, which stream to choose. The questions related to the next moment, next move, when we are on crossroads, the answers get very highlighted in a very specific way when you are meditative. Meditation irons out all kinds of creases. It's not just for attaining spiritual growth. It is not just for peace of mind. It is not just for health reasons. It encompasses everything. Manas regulates the life of a man. Without manas, what is manushya? Without mind, what is man? Nothing. This cognitive abilities that we all share has to be focused. This focus comes through meditation. The success of material success, business world success, also I attribute to my
ability to meditate well through meditation. I'm always guided from within, especially what not to do. Think of those decisions that you made in your life where you have gone wrong or berserk. How did you come to rightful decisions? Then you will be able to see that it was the heart that guided you. When your heart agreed with your mind, that your decisions were correct. So, mind has to okay it and heart has to give a final signal. Without consulting the heart when we move on, I think often we go wrong. So, allow the heart to be purified so much that instantly it can respond to the decision that we are going to make.